Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the crDroid version 8.5 based on Android 12 for the Redmi Note 10 Pro. So let's get started. So this is an OSS ROM and it has the latest Android security patch level as of now, as you can see here. And this is one of the most feature rich ROMs that you will find around here. So first of all, let's have a look at the launcher. Here are a few icon options. As you can see here, you can change the phone size, icon size. So this is nothing special, so I'll quickly go through this. You can double tap to sleep, change how the status bar happens, like its appearance or its disappearance. And I do not have Google installed, so these options are blacked out. And you can customize the app drawer, and also there are certain miscellaneous settings where you can use a taskbar for opening and switching apps anywhere. And you also have the option of show grid of recent apps. So this is basically nothing special, basically the last two things. The first app is shown in full screen and other apps are shown in the smaller windows, as you can see here. It looks weird to be honest, but I didn't get around to turning it off. And here are the quick setting options. There are a few of them, as you can see here. And initially it came with this internet thing which had both the Wi-Fi and mobile data combined, so I replaced that. And here's the stuff. Let's go in deeper. So about the battery life has been quite phenomenal for me, and I'm able to pull around 6 hours of screen on time on a full day of heavy use. So battery life has been pretty great and performance is super awesome. It is super smooth, especially if you compare it with the stock ROM. So let's go here. Here are the crDroid goodness settings, and these are 2 months, so I'll just quickly go through them, otherwise the video will be too long. As you can see here, you can customize what is shown on the status bar and not. You can change where the clock is shown, and here are the clock and date settings. You can auto hide it, and you can also show the seconds, hide AM PM, show the date, and change where the date will appear. And you also have the date format, so you can see like there are a lot of features. And you can change to the old style signal icons, but let's go back. And let's see, you can choose to show 4G or LTE, whatever you want. It doesn't really make a difference. And you can combine the signal icons. You have the roaming indicator, you can turn that off. So let me just quickly turn off the date, otherwise you cannot really see the stuff I'm changing up here. And you can sure hide the VoLTE icon or the VoLTE Wi-Fi icon as well. So currently the VoLTE Wi-Fi is not showing because I have turned off the Wi-Fi. You have location privacy indicator, mic and privacy indicator, so you can disable them if you don't want, but they come in pretty handy in terms of privacy oversight. And you can change how the battery circle looks, as you can see here. And you also have the option for showing a battery bar on the top, and you can change the brightness by sliding across the status bar. And you also have the option for smart pull down, so basically every time you will be pulled into the quick settings if there are no notifications. And here are a few quick setting customizations. As you can see here, you can change stuff up, like how you want it to look in the quick settings. You also get a battery estimate if you want. You can position the brightness slider at the top or at the bottom, or you can always choose to show it. As you can see here, it is visible. And this is some stuff. You can just read through that, nothing special. And you also have the option for clear all notification button. As you can see here, you can change up the button style. Okay, so there's nothing to dismiss, so it is not showing up. You have media cover art. You can force a small lock on the lock screen. You have double tap to sleep, fingerprint authentication vibration can be turned off, but I keep it on. And similar thing for the error vibration. You have the power menu, ripple effect. You also have the option to show arrow keys while you are typing. So basically you can use these to navigate to the text. And you can also disable the navigation bar at the bottom of the screen. as you can see here, and it still works luckily. So let's just keep that enabled. And you also have some quick swipe actions, as you can see at the bottom, and you also have some button options. You can show up this stuff in your power menu, as you can see here. And I have enabled the advanced restart because it comes in handy from time to time if you want to go directly into the recovery. And you can end the call by pressing the power button or long press to wake up the torch. You can also control the playback, answer calls, reorient. You also have ambient display options, as you can see here. So there is a certain warning, you can always show the display, but this drains the battery quite a lot, so I keep that off. And you also have the option for music ticker on the ambient display, and also enable edge lighting. So basically whenever a notification pops up on the edges, you'll see some sort of light of whichever the color you choose. And you have also sensor based options to wake up the ambient display. Let's go in. You can force certain apps to go full screen. You have some smart pixel options. So basically if you turn this on, certain number of pixels would turn off. This saves the battery and also provide protection against screen burn-in. So that is pretty cool. But let's just keep that off, because it makes the screen a bit hazy, but it comes in handy from time to time. You have some mono settings. You can use a custom color. So let's see what it does. Okay, so it turned kind of reddish. Luckily I could turn that back. You have some number styles, but I'm using the gestures, so there's no really need for me to show that. And you also have some font options. Okay, let's select this one. This looks nice. So as you can see here, it's just that easy to switch the font. You have certain icon pack options as well. So let's use the sky ones. They are easily noticeable when I change them, so that's why I choose them generally in my videos. So as you can see here, it has changed. Let's go back. You have signal icon style. Okay, let's go with the zigzag. Nice. You have a Wi-Fi icon style and icon shape, as you can see here. So basically this will change up the icon shape on the desktop, as you can see here. Let's go in, and here is the notification ticker, heads up, force stop button will be shown when in the long press menu of any app. And you can also blink the flashlight for an incoming call to catch your attention better, especially when it's on silent mode. You have certain sound options. You can even customize the volume steps, so this comes in handy when you're listening to music and you just want to get that exact amount of loudness. You can also have the volume panel on the left, as you can see here, and you can vibrate on connect, on call waiting or disconnect, so you know what is going on. And here is some signature spoofing, but I haven't really tried that because I haven't really tried gaming yet. But here are a few gaming options which help you stay focused on the game and not get distracted by notifications and that kind of stuff. As you can see here, you can also prevent accidental touches by disabling swipe gestures. And you have unlimited photo storage option as well. You can spoof your device as a Pixel XL for Google Photos to take backup, and you can swipe to take screenshot, and you can also block screen and button inputs when the device is in your pocket. But I haven't really had the device work up in my pocket, so I'm not really worried about that. And this ROM also has the face unlock option. It works really well. And under the display section, you will find certain extra features, like you can extra dim your phone's screen beyond minimum brightness, but I don't really need that, so I keep that off. You have nightlight option, which you can customize and schedule as well. So you can basically change the intensity for the nightlight, and you can change how the colors look, natural, boosted, stuff like that. So okay, so I guess yeah, I've turned that off. And you have certain peak brightness or minimum refresh rate options if you want to customize that. It is pretty nice to have. And you can also adjust per app refresh rate, so that is pretty awesome. So overall, this is a very well balanced ROM, and especially if you are someone who loves customization features, this is the ROM to have, because there are tons of customization features and if you are a customization lover like me, this is the best ROM for you. Performance and battery life, as I mentioned, is great, because under heavy use it is still able to give me around 6 hours of screen on time after full day's use, so that's amazing. So what do you think about this particular ROM? Are you going to be flashing it? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and make sure to hit that like and subscribe button.